It makes me wonder, all those years of auditioning and being told that people aren't writing or seeing you and you're falling through the cracks, if you start to take a measure of the business based on those failures, and you know what I mean? It would, I think it'd be hard not to get a little cynical about how I look or what I do.
Oh yeah, absolutely.
And would you sort of like turn on yourself and draw conclusions a little bit on?
It would bother me because I knew I was good. You know, it bothered me because I knew that the thing that was making me not get this job was because the person didn't think I looked right. You know, it wasn't because, like, I had a director come up to me once in a diner in New York who was like, hey, you don't know me. I direct a lot of commercials. You audition for me all the time. I think you're great. You're always one of the people that I want to hire. You're always so funny. The client always wants a normal looking white dude for the product. You know, they always want bland white guy.
It's terrible.
Yeah. And he was like, so I just want to tell you, like, again, like so many people in this phase of my career are very sweetly saying, don't be discouraged. You're not wrong. You should be doing this. It's a really hard sell.
But that's almost more discouraging.
Oh, it's crazy.
Because it's like, if it was that you're not good enough, you could go, I can get better.
Oh, or I'd be like, if I spent 12 years with people being like, you're not very good at this, or you're not very funny, I would have done something else.
Right.
I didn't want to do this so much because I was like, I want to do this. I wanted to do this because I think I'm good at this. And I'm pretty sure I'm right. You know, but like to have there be so much feedback that like, they just don't see the guy that way. Or, you know, somebody was like, you know, oh, they've already cast the character, the actress who's playing your sister, and she's white. So you kind of, and I'm like, well, I'm white. So like, I don't know what we're doing here. Like, this is a wild conversation to be having. I know I look like, because then I would also get called in to play any various, you know, ethnicities.
Right.
Across the
Middle
board.
Middle Eastern or?
All of it.
Indian.
Or... Yes, all of it, you know, and then, but inevitably casting would be like, well, are you actually at all Indian? And I'd be like, oh no, not at all Indian. And they'd be like, oh, well then what are we doing? We can't cast you.
Did you ever get cast as a Greek guy?
I'm trying to think if anybody has been Greek. I don't think so.
That's the irony of all of this.
Oh, yeah, yeah. No, I don't think I've ever been Greek in any of my roles.
Just in your life.
Yeah, just in my life. I like to think they're all secretly Greek.
I mean, it's kind of crazy when you think about it.
Oh, like, yeah?
There's no name for what you're experiencing. It's not racism. It's not discrimination.
No.
But it's weird.
It's a super... Well, this is... That's where you get into what is deeply strange about this business, which is, yes, it's about people's talent, yes, it's about whatever, but it's also about people deciding, I was picturing a one of these guys or one of these women in this part, and it just starts to be like narrowed into very, very like whatever boring kind of versions of, or very traditional versions of, who belongs on TV or who people see, especially when I was younger and I was auditioning for commercials. A lot of the clients, they're like, no, I don't, that guy looks weird, you know? I don't know about that weirdo,
or
that guy's funny, but.
If he's actually white, are we gonna get credit for having an ethnic person?
Yeah, exactly. Oh yeah. So it was, like, that was definitely like a, it was, super disheartening, because it really felt like, I think I'm doing the right thing, I think I'm where I belong, but I just can't quite figure out when and how this is gonna tip in my favor.
Hey folks, thanks for watching. If you like what you just saw, then why not subscribe? Click right here for lots more off camera. And if you wanna see the hour-long version of these conversations, I'm gonna give you the secret link. Here it is, offcamera.com. Check it out.